अद्वैत पंचरत्नम ऑफ श्री शंकराचार्य एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय डी बी गंगोली. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन टू सेशंस. टुडे इज द थर्ड सेशन. एक्चुअली यस्टरडे इन सदसद्विवेक और आत्मानात्म विवेक वी हैव सीन आई एम नेदर द बॉडी नॉर द सेंसेस नाहम देहो नेन्द्रियाणि वी हैव सीन. सो टुडे अंतरंगम न अंतरंगम आई एम नॉट द माइंड नॉर द ईगो दैट इज चित्ता और अहम माइंड और ईगो आई एम नॉट दिस बोथ आल्सो. ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरि ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः. डॉक्टर कृष्णमूर्ति शास्त्री दंबे पुणच कर्नाटक. सो टुडे लेट अस सी आई एम नॉट द माइंड नॉर द ईगो हाउ ऑल्दो देयर डू अकर मुंडेन ट्रांसैक्शंस दैट इज मटेरियल ट्रांसैक्शंस लौकिक ट्रांसैक्शंस वर्ल्डली ट्रांसैक्शंस ऑफ द टाइप आई एम फैट I am fair complexioned, I am young, I am seeing, I am hearing. Since we become conscious or we cognize in the manner my body, my eye, my ear, etc. And secondly, just as in the case of the body and the senses, they become objects to our consciousness or cognition and are cognized to be changing and thereby it becomes very clear or evident that we are not the body or the senses, nor the senses. In the same manner, since there occurs a transaction of the type of my mind, this mind which is distinctly but subtly an object to our consciousness should perforce be separate or distinct from I, that is me. In fact, I am cognizing with the mind as a means or medium, and not that the mind by itself cognizes. I use the mind for cognition, but mind itself cannot cognize. The example or illustration of a telescope mentioned previously can suitably be applied here in this context. Just as the telescope, which is indisputably a gross insentient object, becomes a valid means or pramana to observe or cognize very subtle objects in far off space, the mind too is a means for cognition. The senses are bahihkarana, that is the instruments needed to perceive or cognize objects in the external world. The mind is antahkarana, meaning an instrument of knowledge or cognition that takes place within the body at the psychic level. The karana or instrument, karana or instrument is a gross, insentient, valid means alone. The one who uses it, the mind, as an instrument, viz. I am verily a conscious being. Apart from this, the mind is wavering and wandering here and there. If the mind and the senses get linked up or related, then only we, through the mind, get cognition of some object. For this reason alone, quite often, even if we hear the sound or see objects, we keep saying in the manner, why did you say, I did not clearly hear. It appeared as though someone came and moved away. I did not properly reckon. On such occasions, the reason for not registering or reckoning the usual cognition either of sound or sight is nothing other than the mind having had wandered somewhere else. From this reasoning, it becomes tantamount to concluding that the changing, flowing mind is different from the steady eye who cognizes its change or flow. Yet another objection may arise quite naturally, and that is what is stated above. Let us accept that too. In every work aided transaction of the type I cognized, I saw, I heard, etc., there is a cognition of I in each one of them. At least, is that I our essential nature or not? If that I alone is our essential nature, Then what the common run of people who believe that I am in the body and I cognize with the mind, I transact through the body and the senses, the body exists in one region of the world, amounts to be the correct knowledge alone, is it not? In that case, how at all is the statement about this belief being entertained by the common people wrong, and that assertion of I am Parameshwara or the Lord Creator Himself eternally pure and free or liberated be sustained? A consolatory tentative solution to this is, when we are carrying on our workaday transactions, day-to-day transactions, the I that is associated with each one of them is not the real essence of our being. The antakarana or inner instrument of the mind mentioned above alone appears in us in this form. In the transaction of the type, I am cognizing this object through the senses. The change that occurs in the antakarana which performs the act of cognizing is called by Vedantins manas. The change which assumes the form as the kartru or agent of action for the cognition they call ahamkara. Barring this one difference or distinction of appearing as kartru and karana, there does not exist any difference whatsoever between manas and ahamkara. So these are all different pravrittis of the same antakarana. Antakarana has four pravrittis: manas, chitta, buddhi, ahamkara. That is mind, chitta, or the previous deeds, its results, and or memory, we can say previous. So mind, memory, and intellect, and I sense, ahamkara. Barring this one difference or distinction of appearing as kartru and karana, there does not exist any difference whatsoever between manas and ahamkara. In fact, both these are changes or mutations of the ahamkara alone. Therefore, just as the mind is separate from us, to wit, our essential real nature of being, in the same way, this ahamkara called I notion or concept too exists quite separately from our essential real nature of pure consciousness or Chaitanya Swarupa. To be able to realize the truth that ahamkara is different from our essential nature of being or Swarupa, we have to observe very subtly certain conditions. Just as in our workaday transactions, every now and then the mind is not within the purview of our cognition, in the same manner this ahamkara too is not cognized. If observed keenly, because of the reason that we are always immersed or engrossed in external objects, only unless we make a specific effort and bring it into our focus, this I notion does not at all loom clearly before us. Only those who have undertaken the deliberation on the ultimate absolute reality, as enunciated in the Vedantic science of spirituality, as separate in the manner I this make this I an object for their consciousness or cognition. To the rest of the people, this I notion is not easily cognizable. Especially when we are fast asleep, there is no trace whatsoever of this I notion. Even so, none of us ever believes that in deep sleep, our Swarupa or essential nature of being itself does not exist therein. Therefore, only appearing in the waking and the dream, this notion of I, which is an instrument for our workaday transactions, in each of them as ahamkara, it is distinctly separate and our swarupa is separate. This is the final conclusion that is established. So that is, I am not the mind nor the I sense or ahamkara or ego. Next, what we see, I am not buddhi or intellect. Just like the two forms of ahankara and manas, the antahkarana has a third form called buddhi or intellect. When the cognition of the external objects are presented by the senses, it is the function of the mind to cognize them one by one. When these individual knowledges are conjoined by the mind and the latter presents them to the intellect, it determines the manner, this is such and such a thing. The judgment or analysis is by the buddhi or intellect. So mind is just sankalpa vikalpa, that is various types of thoughts mind does. This knowledge or cognition I cognized it to be such and such a thing. Then my means of this knowledge of external objects, either happiness, sukha or grief, dukkha, occurs. Because these sukha dukkha are engendered in us only, to enjoy or experience them and to cognize them distinctly, ahamkara alone is the instrument. In any case, since the intellect too is, like the ego and the mind, merely an instrument of cognition or knowledge, and it is being cognized by us, it amounts to saying that the intellect is separate from our swarupa. The mutations that occur in the ahamkara, in the forms of manas, buddhi, ahamkara, as also the changes like happiness, sukha and misery, dukkha, desire, kama, anger, krodha, fear, bhaya, shame, lajja, etc., are called vrittis or thought constructs. The mind, intellect and ego, etc., are vrittis concerned with the cognition, whereas happiness, grief, etc., are vrittis called vedana, concerned with the experience, anubhava, of the external objects. So, vritti is concerned with cognition or perception, and vritti is like vedana or experiences, perception and experience. Because all these vrittis do occur in the ahamkara alone, and because this antakarana is merely a sadhana or instrument, evidently that my swarupa or essential nature of being, for which it is a sadhana, is distinct from this ahamkara and vrittis. None of these is in truth my swarupa. Thus, a viveki or discriminative person should determine. I think we will see the next portion in the next session. I am not the group of prana. In the next session, we will see. Hare Rama, Om Tat Sat. So, this is the third session of Advaita Pancharatnam.